And welcome to this new video. Today we're going to unbox the Cabas Well, which is a brand new speaker by the French manufacturer Cabas. When you hear some random noises from the background, it's just a friend of mine. You can say hello.
Hello, guys.
So yeah, we are going to unbox the speaker now. Yeah, maybe some of you haven't heard of it yet. Cabas isn't that famous, so yeah, they usually sell high-end audio gear. And this is their first portable speaker. It goes for about 260 euros, which is very pricey, as it is smaller than a JBL Charge 3. And yeah, I don't know if I should like it, because many big high-end manufacturers have failed at the attempt of making a portable speaker. For example, Bowers & Wilkins, or there was another company, I don't remember it yet. But they really failed at their attempt of a portable speaker, because they probably totally underrated the competition. But let's see how this one is doing. So let's cut the foil open here. So I got a start here, and let's rip it apart. So from their website, it seems quite promising. They are claiming 120 watts of power, 4 drivers, so yeah, it seems quite good. Especially because we have seen the Denon Envaya lately, which is a very, very nice speaker in the same class. And it should have, I think, 30 watts, while this one has 120, and I think 60 watts of RMS power, which is quite a bit for such a small speaker. Let's take it out here. Again, packaging looks very nice, but this is what I expect for the price I paid. And let's lift this. And there we have the speaker. So just some manual, and the speaker probably in some kind of carrying bag. So it's quite tight in here. And yeah, it's also very heavy, and as you can see, it's already turned on. No idea why. Maybe they forgot to turn it off.
Battery medium.
And let's take this out here. I know there are two things. So yeah, in here we just have some charging things, or charging brick. Let's see what cable it has. I think it's micro USB. So it is a proprietary charger, which is quite disappointing, as speakers in this size, which have quite small batteries, really don't need a proprietary, I think, 18 volts charger. Micro USB or USB Type-C would have been totally fine. So yeah, quite sad, but this is yeah, okay. So at least the speaker should sound nice. And let's unwrap it here from this kind of thing. Let's see how we can get it off, yeah. And let's take it out. As you can see, I got the black color. It's also available in white. And yeah, it looks quite nice and high quality, but it's pretty small. So you can see, yeah, it's nothing that big. Also, when compared to other speakers, for example, the FIFA Reykjavik, you can see FIFA Reykjavik is quite a bit bigger, while still being $60 less expensive, which of course might be a big, yeah, I don't know, negative point with the Cabas, as usually speakers in this price category are much bigger and can of course also have bigger drivers and deliver more bass and just more sound. Which, yeah, might be a bad thing for the Cabas, but of course we will have to check it out and see how it sounds. So now I will put up my headphones and my normal microphones, and I will do the sound check, comparing it to other speakers, for example the JBL Charge 3 or the Denon Envaya, and we will see how it performs, as I expect quite a lot. I mean, 60 watts of RMS power, or I don't know, just 60 watts of amplifier power, which is quite a bit for such a small speaker, 4 drivers, and also, yeah, made by a known hi-fi brand. So it's quite promising, and we will check it out now. So please wrap your headphones, as this is the only way to listen through binaural microphone recordings, and enjoy the sound check. Okay, so let's start with the sound check now. We will turn it on here. Me and my friend have already taken a listen to it, and well, let's say it's pretty bad, especially for this price. So yeah, to take it away, they copied the driver of the Bose SoundLink Mini. So they have the same full range drivers and the, I think, almost identical passive radiators, although I think the passive radiators in here are even smaller than on the Bose. I checked them, and this one sounds a little bit better, maybe better DSP or probably a stronger amp inside, but this sounds really familiar to the Canton Music Box XS, which was another copy of the Bose SoundLink Mini, but just claimed that it had 60 watts of power. So maybe they copied the copy of the Bose SoundLink, which is just, yeah, that's just basically, it's just a ripoff. Especially for this money, they probably try to sell it under the name, wow, Cabas, such a known brand, but well, it sounds pretty bad. So first, let's try it against the Denon Envaya here. Oh, I just turned it off. It was turned on already. And this one pretty much is the best one in the class so far. You can see it's maybe a little bit bigger, but it's also $60 less expensive. It's waterproof, it has a better battery life, and as you will hear in some seconds, it also sounds quite a bit better. As you can hear, we still have those sounds turned on here. And let's try it now against the Cabas. And I will start with a heavy bass track from SoundCloud. You can hear it already distorts. Does it sound very good? There is just no competition. Can see we are at about, I think, yeah, maybe 60% volume with the Cabas, and it already starts distorting and compressing, which is weird because you either get distortion or compression, but with this crap speaker you get both, which is just irritating. You know, it's a very good company, I know they're big speakers, actually pretty promising, but this small thing, it just sounds crappy compared to the Den, and the Den is so much better. Let's maybe check out another track here. One I use quite often. Oh no, let's check out a new one first and then I will check out the one I use quite often. So let's start with the Cabas again at again 60% volume. This is a NCS track with pretty heavy bass kicks. You can hear the distortion. Let's try out the Denon. You can hear the bass kicks are totally out of control. Probably they push the bass way too far, same issue as with the Bose, and those small drivers just cannot take it. The Denon sounds way better. It's in a totally different class than the Cabas, despite being $60 less expensive and not being designed by a French engineering speaker company, which claims to be one of the best in the world. So let's check out the other track here. Again, distorting bass. Tell me how you feel. Why can't you take me closer? I could be the wind. I could take you higher. If I could see the sun, could I be your fire? So you can hear it sounds weak, it sounds underpowered and also out of control. I don't know, I'm highly disappointed by them. It's again a big hi-fi company, they are quite known in the hi-fi business, and then they come up with this small speaker here. B&W has also tried this with their B&W T7 and it massively failed as well. It was, I think, $350 and it totally sounded like crap. Also, now I know it, the Kev Muo or Muo, whatever, the small version of their high-end speaker also totally failed. I think it was $300, so even more expensive than the Cabas, and it also, I think it was mono sound, so it wasn't impressive at all. And companies like JBL or Denon really blow those away. But now, as they are stating to be a hi-fi company, let's check out a jazz track by Van Morrison. I think we will crank it up two notches more. In some seconds you will also hear that the Denon has way more stereo imaging, thanks to the max audio processing. It sounds dull, the mids are covered.
take my hand. Got to walk with me. In some town it feels like eternity. Can I turn the tide? I'll get back my pride. Can I make you proud? Won't you say it out loud? Well, I'll take you down to the burning ground.
It sounded very unnatural, it sounds unlinear, so there's too much rumbling bass, but really missing the precision and deepness. So the dance sounds better in any way. More powerful bass, much better mids, way clearer, nicer treble, and especially more stereo, which is very important for acoustic music, as you usually have many instruments across the recording, and the Carbass just sounds like one, almost like one mono speaker, while the Denon has this nice stereo processing built in. So I really don't want to hate on the company or to insult the speaker or something, but as you can clearly hear, it's really no competition in a bad way. So let's check it out against something cheaper and also older. This is the JBL Flip 4. Most of you will know it. It's about, I think, just $88 or euros. So less than three times the price almost. And you will hear that even this one, I think, sounds better. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm pretty sure that it can easily keep up with the Carbass as well. You can also see it's a little bit smaller. It has a better battery life. In my opinion, looks a little bit better, more mature. And it's, of course, also more rugged and waterproof. So let's see how this one compares. Again, keep in mind, it's older, about 1 year old already, and it only goes for about $80 to $90.
You don't have to wait. Tell me how you feel. Why can't you take me closer? If I could be the wind, I could take you higher. If I could steal the sun, could I be your fire? I'll take it to the motorway.
So those two maybe are a little bit more comparable than the Carbass to the Denon, but still you could hear the JBL had clean, deep bass kick, while the Carbass just had some, I don't know, some crappy distorted bass, which is just like not acceptable. It's almost $300. This is as much as, I don't know, the new JBL Extreme 2. It's twice the price of a Dokken Define, and those will sound even better. And again, it's $60 more than the Denon, or $60 more than the FIFA Reykjavik, or almost $100 more than the mini rig. So yeah, it's really a total rip-off for this kind of money. Let's maybe check out another track from SoundCloud with the Flip 4 again. Let's see if I can find one here. Maybe this one's good. So you could hear, neither does it sound very powerful, nor does it sound very clear or hi-fi-like, so it's something in between. Yeah, it's just on the level of the Bose Soundlink Mini, which is about 5 or even 6 years old by now, and this for $300 or almost $300, which is, again, way too much. Let's check out another track by Nigel Good. And let's maybe crank it up 2 notches more. About 80% volume now.
Mm-hmm.
circuit again here typical bass reduction from the JBL, although it still remained clean sounding, still remained good sounding. Maybe again a little bit too harsh, a bit too much treble. I think it also was louder here just due to the treble boost, but you could hear the cabas again. It had almost no chance. It was somehow very, very dark sounding, not very, I don't know, brilliant, missing resolution, and especially missing the bass kick. Just was some upper bass, so nothing serious. And let's maybe try one more track, also a little bit, softer again, not this loud anymore. And let's see which one again sounds better. Here I can already tell you, but you should listen for yourself. Again, it sounds covered, no resolution. And the distortion is especially annoying. I think this already says everything. I don't need to compare it to any more speakers now. You can hear even the JBL, which is about $88 or $85, I don't know. It's under $100. Even this one outplays the Cabas. I think it's as loud or even louder. I expect the Cabas to be about as loud as the Bose Soundlink Mini, and this speaker isn't very loud, and the JBL is louder, so I expect it to be louder than the Cabas as well. The Denon is louder than the JBL, so obviously way louder than the Cabas with more bass. And on max volume, the Cabas also sounds very compressed. It has heavy volume dropping, just as we know from the Bose. Now it's not a Bose remix anymore, which is happening on max volume, but some kind of hi-fi Cabas remix with, I think out of control hi-hats and distorted bass, which is unacceptable for this kind of money. And I want to show you one more thing, or I want to try one more thing. I will turn on the Denon again. And I want to see if it has a boost for low volumes, so if it has loudness built in, so that it slightly boosts the bass for lower level listening, so that they don't sound totally tinny. The Denon has this built in, so the lower you turn it, the more bass it will get, which is of course bass adjusting for the human ear loudness curve, I don't know. So let's just check it out. So you can hear it's very full-bodied sounding. Yeah, at least it has this built in, so it doesn't sound totally tinny on low volumes. But the Denon still sounds clearer due to the natural sound. I mean, it always sounds better. And this also works for low volumes. So as you could hear from the last track, the Cabas at least has a bass boost for lower volumes, but again, I rather take a speaker which has normal sound on volumes above 30% than one which has a small bass boost, as this really is the least thing you can expect for this kind of money. For 260 euros, it should offer everything. It should sound better than anything else in this class, otherwise they would have to get down the price, as I just don't accept this. I mean, it definitely earns a place in the Hall of Shame. Next to some other speakers which failed, like the V-Moda Remix, I think it was 350 euros. The Kev Mu, of course, which was a big disappointment from a big hi-fi company as well. The B&W T7, again, also I think being 350 euros, also not sounding competitive whatsoever. And of course, also next to the Canton Music Box XS, as it also just copied the Bose Soundlink Mini. And now, again, we also have the Cabas in there, as there's really nothing special about this. Yeah, it feels quite nice in the hand. It's portable. The company, of course, it's a very known brand again. It's very famous for making good hi-fi speakers, and I have heard one of them once and I was quite impressed by it, but this just is unacceptable. They took the drivers of the Soundlink Mini, copied them, put on the same tuning as Bose, and then just sold it under their brand name for about $100 more, while not offering good sound whatsoever. You could hear even the JBL Flip 4, which is older, less expensive, and even smaller, could outplay the Cabas. Not talking about the Denon here. The Denon is in a totally different class than the Cabas, despite being less expensive again, about 60 euros less expensive. And that's just a big shame for such a known and good company. At least as I thought, I don't know, because this is really not good for this company. Again, they just took the drivers of the Bose Soundlink Mini, which many of them did. At least Bose achieved something with this technique. So 5 years ago, it definitely was the best speaker on the market. It was the first one to offer mature sound in a small package, as we just said, something like the Beats Pill before, and those were even worse than the Bose Soundlink Mini. But by nowadays standards, even Bose has realized that their speaker really isn't competitive anymore, and they have released a newer version, which is the Bose Revolve. But there are just other dumb companies which keep copying them. For example, Canton, again, it's a hi-fi brand, and they just took the drivers from Bose, copied them, built them into their speaker, made it in a different shape, threw on the same tuning, and then again sold it for the same amount of money, which is unacceptable. They have the potential to be so much better, just like Cabas, but they just mess it up with, I don't know, totally underrating the Bluetooth market. They probably think, yeah, we are a known hi-fi brand, we can sell our speaker for as much as we want, we will be the best anyways. Well, if you think like this, you have been wrong, you failed miserably, as there are other speakers, even cheaper speakers, smaller speakers, which outplay this, as you could hear from my video. Again, I don't want to rant on the company, everyone earns a second chance, so maybe if they come up with a second version, it will blow away anything on the market. But if the company is watching, this speaker definitely is not competitive, especially at the price point. 250 or 260 euros is way too much, it's overpriced. You can hear the JBL Flip 4, which used to cost, I think, 130 euros, sounded better than the Cabas. So if you want to sell the speaker and, I don't know, bring some units to customers, you would need to sell it for, I think, maximum $110, because the sound is just pretty bad for the money you are paying for it. So yeah, again, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like on this video or subscribe to the channel. Until then, have a great time and bye-bye. Shouldn't be that big.
Kein Speicherplatz auf der Speicherkarte. Fuck!